So yesterday I played a little bit with doing some stuff with a single executable file. So having a like system service process with different permissions spawned from a single executable file. Now that's pretty cool. And the base idea I explained in my first two chapters, but let's just expand a little bit on that. I haven't logged in yet. Let's see, we have, if all goes well, yeah, CD my one shot. So we have some stuff here, and it's basically a module. Now, first what we can do is basically clean this up a little bit. So ls etc systemd, I'll just go to root by the way, sudo shell. All right, and then ls etc systemd, and then system. Oh, system typo. So here we have, let's just move this one back for now. Try to see if we can make some well, that's ugly. So let's fix this. That was really nasty. Hopefully didn't mess up too much. Seems okay still. Let's try that again. And then sorry, and then use it as a template. So let's first clean up some of the stuff. My one shot nano. My one shot E. Now, the first domain should probably just be an inner daemon domain. By default, it should just run in a generic domain. So, init daemon domain. And then my one shot D, my one shot exactly. Probably. And so this is basically the default to go through to. And basically this stuff here, I'll just comment this out for now, just so that we know. That this is what's going into a template. And this is just an example, of course, how you could set that up. So that's that, and then let's go to the file context file, and let's just clean that up as well. So these are the defaults. This one, I'll comment this one out. And I'll just use this, my one shot. I'll just change that, and just comment this out. And then my one shot. And comment this out. So user share as a Linux. And then it's a module. My one shot. And that's an I for install or insert. And then just edit the LSLC serve. So let's just mv serve instance one. Serve one shot. And ls serve one shot. move that text file in there. And then change that to just S0. So tmod L S0 serve my one shot. Tcom. So the default instance just runs on S0. And then remove okay, so let's clean it all as well. And then basically nano etc system d system and then my one shot service. And let's just change that to basically nothing. Just the default. And then see if that works. And that seems to work. So now we have basically a default setup, and so that by default there's no MCS security, and it's just using a it's the SCUBA type enforcement, but it's just using a generic generic domain, I guess. I'm sorry. One of those days. So ls. I could mv my other one shot service to template service. So now basically what we can do is create a template. That's the first thing, I guess. My one shot interface interface file. No, I'll leave that blank and just do some templates. I guess I could just get that from, for example, less user share selinux dval include, and then sir, actually, yes, I guess I'm not sure where that is. Comtrip, see if that's it. Yeah, and Apache if. Could basically borrow some template from this one here. I guess this stuff here. And paste that in. So create a set of derived types for, I guess, one shot. And it's not quite the right description. One shot. One shot, not one. And I call that my. So I'm sorry. Save exit that and let's have a look at type enforcement file again. And let's try to copy this stuff over. This is basically the default stuff that we need. So we start here by declaring some types. And we need to require the executable file type. Now basically the prefix, this we can just basically make that prefix. And then this, yeah, this, of course, also some generic stuff. So that basically provides you a API for just creating a generic content really fast. And it could be done even more efficient, I think. Yeah, it could actually be done more efficient. I'll just do that. Although have to say that it might that might actually not work, because Fedora uses already uses type attributes in these interfaces. So if I'm if I would basically assign a new type attribute, for example, one-shot domains, to the new to the created type, and then basically call these interfaces with the new type attribute, the one-shot domain type attribute, then you'll have rules that won't build, because then you'll assign type attributes to type attributes, and that's not allowed. You can only assign type attributes to types, so that's one thing to keep in mind. But in theory, you could make it cleaner, the policy cleaner, by writing rules that apply to all my one-shot types, domain types. Then you can basically do that cleaner by just creating a single set of rules in the type enforcement file that apply to a type attribute, rather than for each domain explicitly call these. But in this case, probably won't work, because in these interfaces, probably already use type attributes heavily, so that basically makes it impossible for us to do that. So now we have this one set up, creates a basic template, and so, and then as for the template service file, nano template service, let's see how we could do that. We need to think about that. I need to think about that. But first things first. Basically, what we need to do is create a script that creates a unit file for us, and creates and basically appends. A new domain for us, and I'm just going to do it without any sanity check-in. But let's just create a new script. Nano, my one shot. It's probably a better idea so you have yourself a bin bash or a user bin bash and then basically this expects two parameters, I guess. Expects two parameters. Param one. name, I guess. Instance name, like my one shot instance. Name and then param 2 my one shot category. Yeah, so basically that. So so basically we need, and I'm not going to do any tests, but you'll want to test that those two parameters are there, and that the second parameter is a valid category, and or set of categories, so that's pretty hard to test, I guess. And yeah, for the first instance name, yeah, I guess there shouldn't be any spaces in that name and stuff like that. So yeah, no, I don't do any sanity checking here. I'm just setting it up. So basically what it's going to do is first create, or basically append something. So basically cat and I'm not sure if that's actually going to work, but we'll see. Cat my one shot TE EOF. And then basically probably not gonna work though. Excuse my coughing. And then my one shot content template, I think it was. I guess I could just check that out. See if that will work. That will work. Actually, that wouldn't work. Actually, that would work, actually. Because you need to run it like this. Put in a space there, and yeah, that's supposedly, I guess, in a space in here. And then with regard to the category, so you'll get the following cat my one shot cloud context EOF. And then serve S1D and then gen context system U object R and then S1 data T and then basically S0 and then S2. That seems to be fine. So now when you run it, you have test and category C22. And let's have a look at that nano. So here we have the test set up. Let's just clear that, by the way. And then file context file. You have your category set up. Now if all is well, that also builds. Oh, and actually that's not quite it. We'll just copy this over as well. So that's that, I guess. We could do this like that. Now we'll remove this for now. Let's see if we did that right. So if one said do. That seems okay. Now we have to take care of that unit file. So basically what we're getting is got template. And then open the script again, and then just cut. Not sure if this is going to work. Place this in. And then just change that to and then without the extra. Let's have a look at less user has been my one shot. That seems right. So let's see if that would work altogether now. issue here. So this works. Oh, and we forgot to actually append the file context for that. But this stuff seems to work. And the type enforcement also works. But as for the test service also works, or at least seems to work. Actually, I can just nano my one shot. But oh yeah, I forgot to EOF. Oh yeah, no, I basically also need to edit etc actually user lib system. I need to kill some process, I guess. System B system. And then it's S1. Context. System view. Object. R. And then S1. Unit. File. T. S0. etc system D system. Then just make f user share as a Linux dval make file my one shot pp. Then se I'll leave the installation. Well, that would be it. something like that. Let's see if that actually would work. So let's first do PSX. See if I have some dead scripts. Doesn't seem to be like that. So RM test service. Yes. RM template service. Yes. And then nano my one shot FC. Remove this one. So these are the basics. Oops. And this can be removed. I'm just going to make this test, so I'll just change this to test for now. It makes but yeah, there's no sanity checking in there, so now let's have one final look at the setup so that I can be pretty sure that make those service one. Let's see if that will work. Hope I don't do something really bad. Invalid argument. Wow. Yeah, so that's a bad idea. Very bad idea. no sanity checking. Yeah, the asset service file. Let's just get that though. See if that's. In general, that looks good, I guess. Okay, let's try that again, but now properly. Still not working. Oh, actually, that might actually be old. Yeah, I need to clear that up. So that's a mess. I forgot to clean it up. Nano, my one shot T. I forgot to clean it up. See, this still was in there, which basically messed the whole thing up. So yeah, I need some sanity checking in there, obviously. Valid argument. Oh yeah, right. Valid argument. So yeah, I need to run it with two arguments and directory already existed. That's weird. It reset it to. That's weird. Okay, go back. Need to make sure that that stuff isn't reset, but I'm not sure. See, I'm specifying here this context. So why isn't it, why is it resetting it to S0? Force to match. Need a range to match, customize as well. Block context. As you manage, of context. List, grab, serve. And for some reason it's specifying it at S0. So my file context specification was not right. That's strange. That's strange. It's kind of hard for me to tell. There should be a way to deal with that properly. Takes a little while. Policy, working directory, policy, and then probably support. Actually, no miscellaneous patterns, maybe. No miscellaneous macros, maybe. Context, MLS sensitivity, and then another comma. So I think I specified that wrong. Give me a break. But it doesn't seem like it that it will. So I think I specified that wrong here. So it's actually not a comma here, as as far as I can see. And I did clean up my shit, didn't I? Yeah, I did. So let's try that again. Alexis, yeah, I know it does. Yeah. Now it's fixed. So I specified that wrong. Now system control start test lsoz serve test my one shot text. Yeah, so that's set up. Now there's no sanity checking in that script, and you already saw to what kind of shit that can lead to. So let's just get all this stuff. Get etc systemd system test service, and also get my one shot TE and my one shot FC. So this is the whole thing. So this makes sure that the directory cannot be declassified for if someone stupid runs restoreCon or something like that. That stills right. Let's see if, yeah, that's probably also done properly, the context. This will also get into this one here, why I'm actually labeling these scripts, because you can basically make a confined admin that is basically allowed to add new instances, remove new instances and stuff like that. But only, basically what we could do is basically only via the script. So we can basically confine this script as well, and then allow that administrator to run that script with a domain transition, and only allow that script to actually load policy. So although the admin isn't really allowed to load policy, he is allowed to load the policy, but only via that script. And then he's allowed to stop start services, because he's only allowed to basically read the services that are related to the my one shot domain, so to speak. And then he's also allowed to relabel to my one shot data content types from var content types. And then he's also allowed to create directories in, and I can basically make him create those directories with the proper type in the first place. But that's nice, not nice project to take care of, probably in the next chapter, because we did quite some stuff already now. So, but let's just edit the stuff. So now, basically, if you added another instance, and now basically you want to allow that some extra permission. So now basically what you can do is, and I'll just do the following. Basically add this. And then remove the comments. And then manually build it, but yeah, that's the shitty thing that I could actually, we couldn't. we could. Although the shitty thing is that the admin would probably be able to abuse that. But anyways, so yeah, you basically add these rules here, and make F user share as Linux devel make file. Okay, we need to. This is comment. Then as a module, I my one shot. and then just basically edit the unit file to add that, what is it, option extra, and then basically do a daemon reload, although I don't know off the top of my head how to. So you add the extra. But you could also script that in, basically. And you could actually make that really nice. So if you have like a set of permissions that you need to add for each option, then you can basically just script that all in. So if the user adds option blah, then add the rules for option blah. And so that the user, so that the admin really doesn't have to do that much, do that stuff that I did before, edited manually to allow new rules. Because then you basically, now you have basically a mixture between a selinux admin and a service admin. So you want to basically make it so that the service admin can basically do everything he needs to make the instances run. And since the program only has so much options, this should be actually possible, I think. So I could actually just, I could actually also do that. Basically, you'll ask for a third option. If the third option is ping, then basically add the extras option to the unit file, and then basically add to in the rules related to ping, something like that. But then basically, it is possible. It's a little bit tough though, but so system control and then start test. But it's probably didn't work because you need daemon reload probably. Oh, it actually did. So yeah, it ran ping. Out search and ACTS 1154 and it ran clean. So yeah, it actually works. But if I, for example, run, well, if I would, for example, run my one shot with the extra command, then that wouldn't work. So yeah, that's something to think about. But I'll leave that to your imagination. But anyways, so we know, I'll just explain it one more time. So you know that if the user runs ping, you need these permissions. So if that ping, that extra option, so I have an extra option in my program, and when it basically, when option two is extras, then it's going to run ping. So you know that these permissions are needed when the program runs ping, and so, and when the extra options is given in the unit file. So you can basically script that into your script and say, okay, if option three is extra, then add the rules in for ping and add an extra option to the unit file. And then you'll have basically a my one-shot domain capable of running ping. And that way, basically, you can still confine your administrator, because you can confine the script that creates the policy and loads the policy. So you can basically then allow, if you create the policy for this, for that script, for that my one shot script, shell script, that basically creates the stuff, this stuff, then you can basically say, okay, this administrator can run this script as root with a type transition to a special domain that is allowed to load the policy and allowed to run the script and stuff like that. And yeah, basically, so then you can basically restrict access to that script, and the script can do the policy loading, but the admin can't actually manage the script, so he can't actually change the script, so he can't use that script to basically load policy that he shouldn't be able to load, because what policy should be loaded is all in that side, inside that script. But you just need to make sure that the script, it has no bugs, of course, because else a malicious administrator would be able to abuse the script to add some policy that you don't want him to add. So you need to be really careful there, of course. But in theory, it should be possible. And if your various if your program only has a fixed set of options, then you can basically just do that. Because you can basically look at all the rules that a particular option needs and then just program them in, so to speak, and then just make the script add the rules that are needed when some option is needed. So, and then you'll have basically a menu of, okay, create this my one-shot instance and create it with that type. And created with that name, and created with that category, and enable this functionality, that functionality, and that functionality, and then basically it creates that unit file and adds the options that relate to the functionality, and then adds these selinux policy that relate to the functionality, and then builds the policy, loads the policy, restores the context, creates the directory to work in, and then restores the context. And there you go. And now, next thing you should do is basically, create that admin. So before you do that, you'll actually need to make in this functionality. So, and there's also the problem that the script is just not, it does no sanity checking at all. So that's really something you need to make sure that it's done solidly, because else then it's gonna get really nasty. So make sure your script does great testing, and make sure that it can't be abused, which is pretty hard to do, I guess. This is going to require a lot of tests. But that's for another example. But this is at least some start. It at least gives you an example of how you could go about it. So...